Charlie Munger's Daily Journal nearly doubling down on a China bet, scooping up some shares on the dip. Christina Partsenevelis is here with the name at long last, Christina, and the details.
Oh, Baba. Ain't the black sheep today with shares rising well above 9%. This is Warren Buffett's business partner in crime, Charlie Munger. As Kelly mentioned, he's also the chairman of the Daily Journal that and operates its portfolio business. That's why we care. The latest SEC filing shows the firm increased its stake in Alibaba by 83% last quarter. Shares, though, of Baba, keep in mind, have tumbled to about 32% year-to-date due to regulatory threats in China. And so while others rushed for the exit, Munger doubled down in Baba with at least $40 million earlier this year, which isn't really the norm as he normally invests in American companies. So does that mean the Chinese market is on sale? Many institutional investors just can't agree. We heard about from a lot of them last week, JP Morgan Asset and Wealth Management CEO. She was saying you need to think about rebalancing to areas that have gone on sale. China has gone on sale. And then you juxtapose that versus social capital founder and CEO Chamath Palihapitiya on China. It's a place that I will read about and not invest in. And then you've got BlackRock also urging investors to increase exposure to China by 3 times, while George Soros is saying the exact opposite in the Wall Street Journal. So whether it's increased risk appetite or President Biden's announcement he's going to meet with Chinese president later this year, Chinese stocks are on a tear over the past few sessions. I know, Kelly, earlier in the show, you went through some names, so I pulled up some other ones. So Bilibili, you could see, is up over 10%. Baidu, also up over 5%. Didi, up over 4% right now. But even Goldman Sachs is betting big on Chinese EV firm NIO, saying it could gain 66%. So many on Wall Street right now argue that despite regulatory risks and slow growth, China is just too big to ignore, and its stocks are too undervalued to pass up.
Yeah, listen, we talk to people on both sides of this debate almost every single day. The interesting thing about Munger and Alibaba is that he has time and again expressed his admiration for sort of the autocratic way China runs its economy, often while also expressing his chagrin at how we run ours. So, you know, I think that people understand with their sort of BYD investments and others that he may have the stomach kind of long term for
the at 97.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, long term. Listen, you know, he thinks with a 30-year time horizon.
But for those of, we've talked about these stocks popping just over the last few sessions, but Alibaba is just 50% off of its 52-week high.
K-Web,
it's still
same.
K-Web. I know Alibaba's having the best day since, what is it, June 2017. But this authoritarian regime, they're not going to give away, you know, they want market principles to stay there, but control is getting tighter and tighter and tighter.
Absolutely.
And we don't know necessarily what that's going to mean for a lot of these companies going forward.
I completely agree.
So you have the risk appetite, right? Just
exactly.
Dive in, which is a lot of people are doing that.
Yeah, absolutely. He's probably the most high-profile person who could really kind of plant that stake in the ground. Christina, thanks so much. We appreciate it. Christina Partsenevelis.